Hey, welcome to The Explainer. Today, we're going to dig into a really big idea in economics, one that came from a Nobel Prize winner, and it helps explain the fundamental rhythm of how economies grow.
All right, let's kick things off with a huge question, one that puzzles economists and world leaders all the time. Why can't an economy just keep growing super fast forever? What is it that eventually puts the brakes on?
Well, it turns out this Solow growth model, developed by the brilliant Robert Solow, gives us a really powerful and, honestly, a surprisingly simple framework for understanding why there are limits to growth. Okay, so at the very core of this model, you've got this constant tug of war between two big opposing forces. To really get what's going on, we've got to meet the key players.
First up is capital. You'll often see it as the letter K. Now, just think of this as all the physical stuff an economy uses to make other stuff. You know, the factories, the computers, the roads, the whole shebang. It's the engine of the economy.
So, how do we get more capital? Through investment. This is the force that builds the engine up, adding new equipment and infrastructure every year. A good way to picture it is like pouring water into a bucket.
But, and there's always a but, right? You've also got this other force working against it, depreciation. This is just the inevitable reality that things break down. Machines rust, computers get old, roads crack. It's the slow, constant leak out of that very same bucket.
So you see the battle here, right? On one side, you've got investment pushing everything forward, adding to our pile of tools and machines. And on the other side, you've got depreciation, pulling it back, wearing all that stuff down.
Now, this is where it gets really interesting. The way these two forces dance with each other over time, it actually explains something we see all the time in the real world, why countries that start out poor often grow way faster than countries that are already rich.
Just picture a brand new economy starting from scratch. It doesn't have a lot of machines, right? So the total wear and tear is super low. That leak in the bucket, it's just a tiny drip. Every new investment, like giving a village its very first tractor, has a massive impact. The result? Boom. Rapid growth.
So in those early days, the net growth is just huge. You're pouring water in, and almost none of it is leaking out.
But here comes the catch. There's this crucial idea called diminishing returns. As you get more and more capital, two things start to happen. First, the leak gets bigger. I mean, more machines means more things are breaking down. Second, each new machine adds a little less punch than the one before it. A second tractor is great, but it's not a game changer like the first one was. This combo starts to slow things down.
And so, after years and years of this, that leak of depreciation gets so big that the incoming water from investment can barely keep up. The growth that used to be a flood has now slowed to just a trickle.
And eventually, this whole process brings the economy to a special place, a destination called the steady state. This is that balancing point where the water flowing into the bucket from all the new investment perfectly matches the water leaking out from depreciation.
So what does that even mean to be in a steady state? Does all progress just stop?
Basically, yeah, in a way. The change in capital hits zero. Now, you're still investing, for sure, but every new machine you buy is just replacing an old one that broke down. Your total stock of tools and factories, your economic engine, it's not getting any bigger.
And that's the whole journey in a nutshell. It's a really predictable path. You start small, investment is way bigger than depreciation, so you grow like crazy. But as you get bigger, depreciation grows too, until bam, they balance out, and you hit that steady state where growth from just adding more capital comes to a halt.
Okay, so let's pull all this together. What are the big takeaways from the Solow model? What does it really teach us about how economies grow?
The main lesson here is incredibly important. Saving and investing, absolutely essential, especially for kickstarting growth. But they're not some magic wand for infinite growth. Because of those diminishing returns and the constant drag of depreciation, just piling on more shovels or more factories will eventually be canceled out by the cost of replacing the old ones. You just can't get richer forever by accumulating more of the same stuff.
And that brings us to the biggest, most important question this whole model raises. If just building more stuff isn't the long-term answer, then what is? What's the real secret to lasting prosperity? Well, it turns out the answer isn't about having more capital, it's about getting better at using it. Growth that's driven by ideas, innovation, and technology. But that is a story for another time. Thanks for joining This Explainer.